Hello friends, welcome to Geeta's Kitchen. Today's video, I don't have a recipe for you, but it is a subscriber request. She has asked me to tell her how to do a household budget. Household budget, planning your finances, I feel is something quite personal. It varies from individual and each family's sources are different. But I can give you some general guidelines on how to plan your family's finances. Especially in today's world of cashless transactions, where we use credit cards and plastic money and order for things online, which is a very great temptation also. Beware of swiping your card very often because it really eats into your budget. So very simply put, what are the steps to making a budget? First thing, write down all your sources of income, whether it is a salary or you get any rental income or any dividend, whatever it is. First, write down your income. Next is your expenses. Make a note of all your expenses, however small or big they may be. Everyday expenses like what you pay your maid, your grocery bill, electricity, any EMIs which are due, make a list of all the expenses. Sometimes you have expenses which are not paid monthly. They might be paid even quarterly or yearly. Say like school fees or insurance premium. Supposing you are paying it every quarter, then just divide it by 3 months or 4 months as the case may be and calculate your monthly expense on it. And most important of all, you have noted your income, you have noted your expense. But most important again is your savings. Keep 20% of your monthly income for your savings. Show you a sample of how I write down my expenses. Now, as I told you earlier, this will vary from your expenses, but this is just a guideline. So first of all, you need your total income. Then you have two types of expenses. One is fixed expense and variable expenses. Fixed expenses are those recurring every month which we have to make the payment for. For example, if you are living in a rented house, the figure for your rent will come there. In my case, I have the maintenance which I pay, say around 2500 rupees I pay maintenance in a month. Then the amount I pay to my maid, my electricity bill and your newspaper, how much you spend on, flowers, how much you spend. If you have children, you will have figures here for school fees or any yoga class or gym class. It varies with each family. Then the amount for your internet, your telephone bills, if you have mobile phones, your landline bills, amount for groceries, milk, what you spend on transportation, vegetables and fruits, doctor, medicines, everything that you spend on in a month, note it down. Okay? Then you will know roughly how much you are spending in a month. Now, apart from this, there are some variables also. For example, we need some entertainment, we need to go out for eating. So you set aside a certain amount. This need not be an exact figure. You set aside a certain amount. Now, some months there might be somebody's birthday, you might have to buy gifts for them or somebody's wedding, whatever. So that is again a variable expense. Or you might have some festivals where you spend more or you need to travel for something. So you have a certain amount for all these variables. And apart from this, a particular portion you keep aside every month towards savings and emergency funds, or whether you're investing in SIPs or any bonds or anything. Now, apart from this, make it a point to jot down all your daily expenses with date. I have been doing this for ever so many years. So you just write the date, whatever it may be, whether you bought some fruits or bread or you're given something to the person who irons your clothes, note down and tally it every day and tally at the end of the month how much you have spent. There is supposed to be a simple rule of budgeting which is called as the 50s to 30s to 20 rule. That is 50% of your income you spend on essentials like food and rent, 30% on variables like entertainment, travel and gifts, and 20% on savings. I will give a lot of importance to this 20% of savings, which will really add up to you when you have a lump sum amount. At the same time, allow some flexibility. Maybe there is a month, say in June, you might have to pay the school fees, and that may be a major chunk. And on other months, your major chunk will be on something else. So be flexible enough so that you can take from one and put it into another. So if you stick to your budget, you don't have to really worry about pay your EMI or your credit card payments. Another simple thing what I do, which I have been following for a long time and which helps everybody in the house also, I keep a small amount of money, say about 200 to 300 rupees, in small change, and everything is labeled like this. Here, for example, I have written ironing or small expenses. So let us say I'm a working woman and I'm not present in the house all the time. So even if I'm not there, somebody else can just take from this and they can use it for payment. Similarly, if I need to pay for milk, if I know that I have to pay him 1,000 rupees for milk, I clip it on like this as milk and keep it. So when the milkman comes at that time, I don't have to go searching and then feel that I don't have the money to pay him. Similarly, I made it as for flowers. This is what I made to pay my newspaper vendor, and also for my maid, I pay her. So I have kept that aside. This is what I need to pay for my building maintenance. And so this is again is gas. So let us say I'm away and the gas cylinder has come and I have to pay for it. Then this is readily available to anybody. So I know what all I have paid and what is remaining. So this makes it very easy for me to tackle my household finances. So I do hope you are gaining some valuable tips from all this, and you plan your household finances too, so that life becomes something really very enjoyable. Thank you.